Let my steps be guided by your promise. May evil never rule me. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, my friends, to another one of our live streaming masses. And we lift this up in a special way for all of you at home, with your families. And let us ask the Lord as we begin this mass, for his grace, the grace of the Holy Spirit, to come into our hearts and lives. And let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that schooled through Lenten observance and nourished by your word, through holy restraint, we may be devoted to you with all our heart and ever be united in prayer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people and said, Now Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land, which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. Therefore I teach you the statutes and decrees, as the Lord my God has commanded me, that you may observe them in the land you are entering to occupy. Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear of all these statutes and say, This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people. For what great nation is there that has God so close to it as the Lord our God is to us, whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as his whole law, which I am setting before you today? However, take care and be earnestly on your guard, not to forget the things which your own eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your memory as long as you live, but teach them to your children and to your children's children. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion, for he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. He spreads snow like wool. Frost he strews like ashes.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. Amen, I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law, until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of these least commandments and teaches others to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today's readings from Deuteronomy and the Gospel of Matthew kind of bring together several themes that we can apply to ourselves today. Jesus talks all about the law, fulfilling the law. And Moses is speaking to the people of Israel during their time in the desert about the decrees of the Lord. And if we look back at the Israelites, and especially Israel's coming out of Egypt into the desert, the decrees, the laws of the Lord, the decrees the Lord gives them, they are several things come together in those decrees. First and foremost, all of these laws point us to correct worship of God. It's about our relationship with God. But interestingly, these decrees, these laws, commandments of the Lord, also relate to ourselves in the community and the correct ordering of our lives. So just think about it. It is, first and foremost, these rules, commandments, the law, are about our relationship with God, correct worship with God. But also, in being correct, in a correct relationship with God in worship, the Lord starts to order our lives right here and now. There is a rule of life given us by the Lord. The Lord instills holy order into our lives. And Jesus reassures his apostles, reassures his disciples, and us today, that his coming does not take away this law, does not take away this order, but rather he has come to fulfill it, to bring it into its fullness. All right, that's great, Father Michael. How do we take this into ourselves today? Now, I know I'm speaking to all of you at home, and this is a new time for us. You know, our schedules, our daily lives have been kind of turned upside down with this coronavirus. And we're dealing with not being able to go to work for many of us. For many of the families out there, you're dealing with having to homeschool your kids. And it's like, our lives have been turned upside down. Are we throwing out law and order, right? No, absolutely not. I think the Lord's words that he has come to fulfill his law can be applied to us. And we hear from Moses that the nations will say, how great is this nation that has the Lord their God so close to them? God is so close to us, my friends. And there are the rules that we allow the Lord to implant in our hearts for us to live out, keep us close to him. So I was talking with a friend of mine yesterday on the phone at night, and we're going through just kind of the struggles of what it's like to live in this current situation. And one of the things we started talking about was creating a rule of life for ourselves, to literally write down how we're to order our lives. And it reminded me of a great book. I'm going to put this recommendation on my Facebook page and our parish website, the What Now Parish part of the website. But it's a book called He Leadeth Me by Father Walter Cizek. And Father Walter was a Jesuit priest who went to Russia during World War II to minister to the Russian people. He was captured and spent 23 years in solitary confinement or prison camps. And there's this whole experience of the coronavirus, having to be stuck in our homes and removed from people, having a new order to our lives, has brought to mind this book for me in a lot of ways. And about early on in Father Cizek's time in Russia, he was sent to solitary confinement for 5 years and in the prison camp called Lubyanka. It was a horrible, when the Russian people heard that name, Lubyanka, they were like, this is a place of terror, of being crushed. And Father Cizek is sent here to this place. But during this time in solitary confinement, his mind went back to his time in the Jesuits, having a rule of life. And I want to read you just a little, two paragraphs from the book to kind of inspire us to start to think about how can we have a rule of life for us right here and now, for ourselves individually and for our families. So Father Cizek writes, "Very early in my stay in Lubyanka, as the endless tedium of solitary confinement began to get to me, I decided to arrange some order and division into the day. I made up for myself what we used to call in the Jesuit houses at home a daily order. As soon as we were awakened in the morning, I would say the morning offering. Then after the morning trip to the toilet and wash up, I would put in a solid hour of meditation. 5:30 a.m. rising hour and 7 o'clock breakfast in Lubyanka were almost identical to the daily order of most Jesuit houses I lived in. And so the days began to fall into place, into a pattern for me again. After breakfast, I would say Mass by heart. That is, I would say all the prayers, for, of course, I had no way of actually celebrating the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Father Sizak did not have any wine and very little bread during his time, so he couldn't celebrate the Mass. I said the Angelus morning, noon, and night as the Kremlin clock tower tolled over the hours of the Red Square a few blocks from Lubyanka Street. At noon, I would make an examination of conscience as suggested by St. Ignatius in his spiritual exercises. I would make another exam before going to bed at night and also prepare for the points for my next day's morning meditation. Each afternoon, I would say three rosaries, one in Polish, one in Latin, and one in Russian, as a substitute for my breviary, the Liturgy of the Hours. And he says at the end of this chapter that Lubyanka, in many ways, was a school of prayer for me. My friends, right now, as you're at home and we're here struggling with this the virus, almost the prison-like containment of being cooped up, like Father Sizak in the days after World War II had finished, let's make this time a school of prayer for all of us, that we need to allow the Lord to instill holy order into our lives, and that He is not far away. He is near to us, as Moses says, in our hearts, in our lives. And this daily regimen of prayer, this rule of life, can help us to be able to live this out. For all of you who are out there, families are being homeschooled right now. I grew up in a homeschool family, and my mom kept a very regimented schedule. If I recall correctly, we used to get up 6 a.m. every morning, and we had a very similar schedule to Father Sizak. We would make a morning offering, some prayers for the conversion of our family members and friends, and a spiritual communion, something we're doing here as a parish community and or throughout the United States and the world, saying a spiritual communion together. So parents, do you have a rule of life, a daily order for your family? Sit down with your spouse or a loved one or perhaps another homeschooling mom or dad and talk about how you can do this. For those of us just individuals, talk with a friend. I talked with a friend last night. We literally wrote down what our rule of life is going to be. And there were little interesting details that were kind of funny to think about. Okay, get up at a proper time, 5:30. I'm getting up 5:30 every day. Make your bed. Interesting one, get dressed. Don't walk around your house in your pajamas. Get dressed, take a shower, shave. Do the normal aspects of life. But make the first priority prayer. Get up and pray. That's to return to our first reading in the gospel. We put right our relationship with God, this correct worship, giving our whole lives to God, to really know His presence with us. Put this first, literally the first thing we do every day. Suddenly, the Lord will start to create holy order into our lives. And as my friends, as Father Sizak found in his solitary confinement in this horrible prison, this time of confinement can become for us a school of prayer. The Lord is present with us. He is around us, inside of us. We put Him first, we allow Him to order our lives, instill holy order. We will begin to experience joy in the miracles He has planned for us right now. We stand and lift up our petitions to the Lord who knows all of our needs.
For all leaders in the church, may Christ, the source of their wisdom, strengthen their hearts as they teach God's law in our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those responsible for public policy, may God guide them in enacting laws that uphold the eternal law of truth given in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those oppressed by any evil in the world, may Christ bring about justice and sources of healing for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here, may the Holy Spirit give us wisdom to understand all that God teaches and grace to receive Christ's help in our moral struggles. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they rest in the perfect peace of God's presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those special intentions which we hold in the quiet of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And finally, Lord, we lift up to you all those who are ill with the coronavirus, those medical professionals who are taking care of them, the scientists working on a cure, that you would give insight to their minds, O Lord, to be able to end this dread disease. And we pray especially for all families and those struggling during this time of confinement and isolation, difficulties in our marriages and families. Come, Holy Spirit, fill us with peace, unity, and reconciliation, and instill holy order into our lives. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, we run to you, and you come to us always when we ask you. Please now to know your presence here and now, and answer all of our prayers. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, along with these sacrificial offerings, and defend those who celebrate your mysteries from every kind of danger, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that free from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world, so as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold, him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence, O Lord. For those of you worshiping at home, we have on our website, on our What Now page, our spiritual communion services, the prayer there that we can say together. Or if you have the prayer available, please join me. If not, just in your heart, ask the Lord to come in and into it spiritually. We cannot receive him sacramentally. So together, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Thank you, Jesus, for coming into my heart. Amen. Let us pray. May the heavenly banquet at which we have been fed sanctify us, O Lord, and cleanse us of all errors. Make us worthy of your promises from on high. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. Give to your people, our God, a resolve that is pleasing to you, for by conforming them to your teachings, you bestow on them every favor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Friends, we'll say our prayer for protection in time of pandemic. Once again, this is available on our parish website, so we can say this together. It's a novena. Archbishop Laurie has asked us to say together. So my friends, together. O Mary, you always brighten our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain while remaining steadfast in faith. O loving Mother, you know what we need, and we are confident you will provide for us, as at Cana in Galilee. Intercede for us with your Son, Jesus, the divine physician, for those who have fallen ill, for those who are vulnerable, for those who have died. Intercede also for those charged with protecting the health and safety of others, and for those who are attending to the sick and seeking a cure. Help us, O Mother of divine love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who took upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, so as to lead us through the cross to the glory of the resurrection. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.